lunchtime video. Andy's going to ask me the questions. Normally we go do it the other way around, but he's nearly dead, frankly. So it's probably easier for him just to do the little short bits, and I'll do the long talky bits. Hope you've had a lovely weekend, by the way. And what have you got for me?
I was hoping we could get like a really, really small person to like do the sign language at the bottom, like you see. On the BBC after midnight. Yeah. We couldn't find anyone. What's that yesterday, wanna?
It was indeed. We're going to go and do a show about it in a minute. Did the pink yesterday. Thank you to Philip, Paul and Ben for coming down and doing that with us. If you haven't listened to today's subscriber show, it was terrific, really. Got a bit more insightful than the pink often does. It was got a bit tactical for a while there, which was fabulous, because that's what you want to do. You want to talk about how you won 4-1. But it was great. Sturridge babysitting Ojo was phenomenally good. Origi's performance when he comes on is great. Midfield was excellent, felt the pace of the game, suited James Milner. And I believe the Iron Sheik's got stuck in.
Yeah, he did. Well, I mean, before we get into that, we were playing tabloid cliche bingo. The word manager's headache has been mentioned for the first time.
I'm banging it everywhere.
Yeah. The managerial headache, but we'll get on to that a bit. Yeah, the Iron Sheik is banging to Divock, Origi no jabroni, indeed. Another WWE superstar, the Liverpool fan. Who knew?
Seems to be a few of them knocking around the place.
Who knew?
Seems to be a few knocking around the place. Anything else from the game that struck up for you?
Yeah, I thought I'm going to write something on Storage later this week. See, I've committed to it now on video, Robbo. I thought he was looked a little bit sharper. Origi looks, I mean, Ojo looked brilliant, that little bit of skill, and he'd switch sides, that little, that when he'd nutmeg the lad and put the cross, and the cross was amazing, the movement was great. I thought Sturridge looked after him really well, but then Origi second half, you know, I was buzzing off more than anything.
Go on.
The short cross thing.
Oh, and Shawcross's little owl, it's pathetic, isn't it? Absolutely pathetic for Shawcross.
I piece Ryan Shawcross there.
Yeah, kicking off when there's nothing to kick off for. He's just been had off.
Just been had off massively.
And also Hughes dragged Peters because he was...
Yeah, we missed this, didn't we?
Yeah, we've been told about this. When Origi made the Peters and Hughes turned around and said, well, you need to do better than Peters, but what do you want me to do? Before he knew where he was.
It was a bit more colourful than
it
that.
It was a bit more colourful than that, but before he knew where he was off.
He was getting the hook.
The big one really, and we're going to talk about it, a little touch on it in different ways in a couple of the shows this week, is the other thing to take from the game in a strange way, and I was actually saying this last couple of weeks, is Jordan Ibe and the extent to which he's out of favour. Now it's all the social media stuff, and you are beginning to think to yourself it's very difficult to see. In any case, I was looking at it thinking, well, Ojo's overtook him by virtue of the fact that he started this game.
Yeah.
Ibe's response suggests that it's all over by the shouting from a Liverpool point of view for him. And to be honest, that might be the best thing for the player, is that he moves on, because he needs to play regularly, and it's not going to happen for him here, I don't think.
Well, I don't mind. I don't mind the player fuming. It always amuses me when people get the backs up with it when players aren't happy. I don't want players to be happy.
Yeah.
And the only time a player should be happy is if he's playing every week and scoring 2 or 3 goals, if he's a striker or keeping clean sheets, if he's a goalkeeper. Otherwise, you shouldn't be happy. You should always look to improve. But on that as well, it just shows you the folly of footballers having social media. And they obviously get told that it's great by their agents and, you know, brand Jordan.
Yep.
When all anyone's talking about today is, you know, and it's a bit geeky, really. You know, he's removed the Liverpool reference from social media. Who really cares?
Yeah, of course.
You know, but he's got to step up now. He must know now that, you know,
I think the end's nigh. I just don't see where he gets back on the pitch, to be honest with you, because if, you know, let's say Bournemouth next week, you'd think he'd start Ojo ahead of him, then there's the derby, you don't see him starting Jordan Ibe in the derby, and it just goes from there. I don't quite see, you know, regardless of the result against Bournemouth, I just don't see where he gets back in.
No, but as we've learned in the past, never write anyone off.
Nope.
Before we move on from the game, Klopp and Hughesy, do you see it?
Yeah. It was more funny than the clip I saw at the Hughesy's assistant manager laughing his head off about
it was Shaqiri. Had a bit of a dive, and Hughes had said something, and Klopp, who seems to be just needling everyone, goes, "Oh, sorry," obviously not in that voice, and just like laughed it off. But he just seems to be getting under the skin of everyone. I don't mind that.
Oh no, I love that. That's what we need more of. Quickly to rattle through some of the other stuff. It was interesting that Tuchel and Dortmund made 8 changes when they drew 2-2
compared to our 7.
Compared to our 7, which suggests where their priorities lie. And I think this is, I think it would be wrong for us to say that you got the impression that Dortmund were taking Liverpool lightly last week. But there was an element where they did feel as though if they showed up, they'd win. And now it feels as though they're very well aware of the fact that that's not an option anymore. This is a huge game, one that they've got to take deadly seriously on Thursday. We're going to, it's all the week's about, basically. So it's how they're going to do that, and one of the ways they were going to do that was by making any changes and feeling they could get something from Schalke.
Yeah, absolutely. I think it's a compliment to the lads that they made so many changes, especially with Schalke being such a big game. It's not just like another game.
It's the derby.
And apart from the Bayern games, probably their biggest game of the year.
Some of them would even say it was their biggest game of the year. You know what I mean?
It's like the Everton Man United thing.
It's exactly like the Everton Man United thing.
So we'll see. But we're going to have to be on our mettle.
We're going to have to play the very best we can play.
Talking about Everton Man United, specifically Everton.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
You love this, don't you?
Leighton Baines. Leighton Baines telling tattletales. Yeah, he's a little feather, as Baines. He's walking out to Central Station before. I mean, we've known about this interview for years, and we know that it's always there. And Everton are selling the season tickets. They've got these big posters up in Central Station because, you know...
They're Everton.
And it says, Evertonian since 1984. Like, yeah, really?
It's something on the Facebook knocking around on that
Have a look at it. And the next one is in Lukaku, Evertonian since 2013, but it didn't say at the end of it till 2016, because he's off, lads. I think that, and then we had a bit of a laugh, Dejan Lovren.
Yep, kicking off with Croatia, saying that he's not interested in going to the Euros if he's not starting, which is a point of view. I don't know enough about what's going on there with Croatia, but I think it'd be good now for Henderson to go to the Euros. I'd like Sturridge not to, but of course he will do. You'd have thought so if he stays fit between now and the end of the season. He will do. It just knocks onto the pre-season, so maybe him not starting but staying in training could actually be a positive for Liverpool. Brief summer and then back. So you know, if Hodgson wants to go with Kane and Vardy and Rooney or whatever combination he wants, all the best with that, Roy. You've got our full support. And the golf fellow supported Liverpool, you were telling me.
Young Danny Willett, who came from nowhere to win the Masters last night. I think it's been well documented since suddenly people have realised this fella existed.
Yep.
In the last 24 hours that he supports Liverpool. But not only that, we've had a message off his brother, haven't we, saying, "Atalie, we're all red," and Matthew Willett is a tour subscriber, so you know, bit of pedigree there. So right. we're more than happy with that, aren't we?
Well, you are. I'll take anyone, I'm not selective, so if you're thinking about subscribing, this would be a great week to do so. We're going to get as much stuff as
joining
we can
good
for
company.
You
joining good
and
company.
You're joining good company. We're going to get as much good pre-match stuff for Dortmund as we can. We're looking back at the weekend, doing Tuesday interview later with Sean Rogers and Ian Salmon, which is going to partially look at the first Dortmund game, focus on Stoke, but put one eye going forward. That'll be coming out tomorrow.
We've got the big show today
that's coming up. We're going to go and do that right now, and then on top of that, other stuff today. We've got a really good coach home lined up, and we've got a few other little bits and pieces. As I say, the whole focus is on Thursday. For the first time, I just want to let you know, we're not going to be doing any content on Friday. It's the anniversary of the disaster from 1989, of the Hillsborough disaster. There'll be nothing coming out from us then. There will be a show that comes out on Saturday to make up for that, but I'm just letting you know now that there'll be nothing on Friday, day of reflection. So we'll be leaving that one alone, but there'll be loads and loads and loads of stuff around Dortmund between now and the game and the aftermath of the game on Thursday. Yep. All on Tour Player, all on the normal stuff. Why wouldn't you subscribe? It's your call. No. See you in a bit.
Hang on, before we go, it's on a Thursday, because we're doing this interaction thing with our mates who watch the video. Who starts on Thursday?
You want them to say that?
Yeah.
Tell us. I'd probably go, Lallana one side, Coutinho the other, Firmino behind Sturridge.
You wouldn't start with the pair of them. I'd start with the pair. Anyway, let us know what you think.
Interact underneath.
Yeah. Just here, let us know, and if we agree, we'll send by someone a Mars bar.
See you in a bit.